You know, did you know that they're just out in the open now going, oh, yeah, we are spraying aluminum dioxide and barium salts all over the world since the mid-1990s in a secret global geoengineering program. You can see it. CBS News, ABC News. You can go to YouTube, type in John P. Holdren, geoengineering. Watch press conferences. What did all the chemtrail experts, Jim Keith was writing about this in like 92 before I was even on the scene. But the government says they started in the mid-90s. That's when it got widespread. And everything he said, barium salt, aluminum dioxide, and they clearly killed him. And that was a guy ahead of his time. Really knew what he was talking about, Mr. Keith. And when you look at this, you understand how incredible it is that there could be a 15-plus year secret program. And we've got the patents where they add the barium salts, aluminum dioxide to the jet fuel. The airlines don't even know. Then the patent for the engines to disperse it. And then the cover is we're saving the Earth from the sun's rays. Okay, so people 15-plus years ago tested it and said they're spraying aluminum dioxide and barium salts on you and other things. And then now the government comes out and admits that. So we are selling a video that G. Edward Griffin produced. It's very good and is the first film to come out since they admitted a lot of this. This is huge. This is huge. Chemtrails admitted. What in the world are they spraying is the name of the film. It's available at Infowars.com. We'll put it up on screen for folks so they can see it. But if you go to Infowars.com and click on the shopping cart link there, it'll take you to the front page and you'll see the banner where you can buy it. If you want to get it first, you simply go to Infowars.com and pre-order it, and they'll be shipped out in the order they're received starting October 22nd. And again, the name of the film is What in the World Are They Spraying? You can also call toll-free to get it. It's 888-253-3139, 888-253-3139. And your purchase of the film also supports this operation, but also G. Edward Griffin and the filmmakers of What in the World Are They Spraying? The Chemtrail Geoengineering Cover-Up Revealed. 888-253-3139. Or write to us at P.O. Box 19549, Austin, Texas 78760. All right, now we're going back to the Health Ranger. And one of my sales guys pointed this out. They go, you know, the Health Ranger really loves Interfood, and it won their best superfood 2009. And so, ask him what he thinks about it, but I'm putting him on the spot here. But I remember about 5 years ago, I got some of this sent to me, and I was so busy, I didn't even call them back because they wanted to be sponsors. But years later, we came back. My wife loves it. It's two little scoops in the morning in water or juice. You drink it, and it's 20 superfoods at once, and that way you absorb almost all of it. Even with the best vitamins and minerals, a lot of it gets passed through you. And you've got a lot of specials there on the site for Alex Jones listeners. Interfood.com or 866-762-9238, 866-762-9238, Interfood.com. Give us your brief take on Interfood.
I did give it an award, an Editor's Choice Award. It's the real thing. And not only is the product really great, but the company's great. The people there are great. They get it. You know, they understand nutrition. They understand what's happening with the world, and they want you to be nutritionally prepared. I mean, that's the bottom line with this product. It's I use it.
Well, I know my wife gets upset when she runs out.
Yeah, it's really that good.
And she's a lot more health conscious than I am. I mean, I try to be. I mean, compared to the average American, I guess I'm okay, but I do have a lot of bad habits. But I noticed that when I first started taking it, I mean, it was almost like a drug or something. I mean, there's no speed, no caffeine in it, but it's almost like jolting to have real nutrients.
It makes you alert without any kind of caffeine type of buzz. No stimulants whatsoever. It just basically clears out your system, and it makes your brain and body function better. You know, I mean, superfoods are really powerful for doing that. And with Interfood, he's combined a lot of the best ones in the world. I don't give out a lot of awards. You probably know that.
And the key is they don't pasteurize it either, so it doesn't lose the...
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. So you've got the nutrients that are destroyed by heat. In Interfood, they're not destroyed. They're intact, and that makes all the difference.
Absolutely. Okay, let's get back into the salmon and all, and because the FDA admits this is a major change, they're now getting ready to approve hundreds of different GMO crops. They're trying to force Europe to do it, despite the farmers burning down, you know, whole areas whenever Monsanto and others try to plant it. And if they're able to put salmon on store shelves, in restaurants, everywhere, and not label it, not let you know. That's kind of like when Monsanto had their genetically engineered growth hormone in the milk. They tried to sue non-GMO milk makers for just saying we're GMO free. Like, how dare you in America put on a container that you don't have artificial hormones? How dare you?
Yeah, exactly. And that's the kind of outrage that we should all be expressing on this issue. They did. They want you to be not just uninformed, but misinformed. Because the more you know about GMOs, the more concerned you should be about eating them yourself or feeding them to your children or family members. And right now in the U.S., 91% of the soybean fields are genetically modified soy. We have GMO sugar beets creating genetically modified sugar in this country, and that's not labeled either. All kinds of GMO corn being used in the food supply.
And every week or two, I see a headline, GMO corn caused organ failure in rats. I mean, it's constant.
Yeah, there have been a lot of animal studies. You know, Jeffrey Smith is one of the best experts on this, and he's really studied the issue, and he will tell you how dangerous this can be. I mean, we should be concerned, not only because we're not being told the truth, but also because the testing hasn't been done. Have these salmon, these genetically engineered salmon, have they ever really been tested on humans as a food source? The answer is no, and they're not about to be. Now, Alex, this could unleash the floodgates. If the FDA allows GMO salmon into the food supply, they could allow any genetically engineered animal. I mean, it could be fish, it could be genetically modified cows, pigs, chickens, or some animal that we haven't even thought of yet, something they create. You know, they're going to play Frankenfood with animals now and approve that as a food source.
And I've had top scientists on the show, world-renowned, who ran whole biotech companies and morally said, I can't do this. In one case, a potato in England. And they found you can change that one trait to make it taste better, last longer, whatever they're looking for. But then it randomly changes thousands of other things. And then as they breed these over time, the potato strains start mutating,
right.
And we already have genetic pollution where they're already seeing almost no corn strain on earth has not been infected by the GMO. We now see it getting into oak trees. We see the German studies about the honeybees go and eat the BT corn pollen. It kills them. I mean, this is genetic Armageddon.
Well, let's talk about why this really matters, because if you get the corn crops and the wheat crops and the soy crops all contaminated with these genetically engineered DNA, then you could have a susceptibility to a widespread viral infection throughout the crop, a plague of the crops, right? That could wipe out our crops in one season.
It's that genetic diversity that stopped that.
Exactly. So I think that these scientists, by playing God with the food supply, developing these Frankenfoods, they are setting us up for future famine, starvation, crop failures that could just devastate global population.
Yeah, they've always wanted to reduce Africa, Latin America, and Asia's population. That's on record. Once they get them to accept this and their 90%+ of, say, their corn is GMO, it gets wiped out. They're deader than a hammer, and then they don't have the seed stocks.
Right.
And they admit this is a military-style takeover of the planet. I mean, here's a quick example of trusting these people. This is just today. Okay, you have to understand, every day this is in the news. They even admit it. Here's CNN. U.S. apologizes for infecting Guatemalans with STDs in the 1940s. They always report something, 50 years old. The United States apologized Friday for a 1946-48 study that purposefully infected people in Guatemala with sexually transmitted diseases. A statement by the Secretary of State Hillary Clinton and Secretary of Human Services Kathleen Sebelius called the action reprehensible. And it goes on to how they told them it was health clinics and injected them with syphilis and other things. And we know that they had cancer viruses in the polio shots. We know, every year I see articles about people being killed by the polio shots they're being given now. And it's like, oops, it was live. It was a weaponized strain. Oops. Now everybody better take the vaccine we've got or you'll die. And then suddenly their fertility goes down. And we have the Rockefeller Foundation reports that our researchers and writers have been doing a great job digging through. One great guy over in the Netherlands, he's publishing articles multiple times a week where, I always think I know it all. I mean, and then I realize how much I don't know. We literally have found hundreds of Ford Foundation, Rockefeller Foundation, UN reports where they said, we're going to add this hormone to the tetanus shot, sterilize people. Then we have them caught doing it. We're going to put cancer viruses in the polio. They did it all. And that's who killed your grandma, folks. That's who killed your grandpa. And they know what they're doing. And now they've gotten to a point. In the past, they would deny all this. Now they just come out and say, hey, depleted uranium, not bad for you. They know it's going to kill the troops, not bad for you. They now have 500 mobile radiation vans just driving around beaming people. Can you speak to, from your deep research, do you agree with me that, we have the facts, that this is totally staged by design? They are trying to kill us.
Well, it's very clear, actually, the history of medical experimentation on the human race. I published a timeline of that at one point that tracks it, all the events throughout U.S. history, just U.S. history. Most of those experiments involved the military, and they would experiment on certain groups, African Americans or prisoners or people of low economic status. Typically, they would pick certain groups, they would conduct experiments on them, and these are all well documented. This isn't, just pie in the sky stuff. This is all extremely well documented. And many of these researchers later were found out, and they were stripped of their licenses and so on. This stuff, it came out eventually. But like you said, 50 years later is usually the case. But they did. They sprayed the population in California with bioweapons. This goes on all the time. And they will tell you later only if they get caught. But it's happening right now with the vaccines. H1N1, swine flu vaccine. The evidence now says that those who were vaccinated against swine flu now are at greater risk of catching the next seasonal flu. So it actually weakens your immune system.
That's mainstream news. And you said all this over a year ago when it was happening.
Yes.
And now the British Medical Journal's come out and said it was a fraud. It's dangerous. They've suspended the flu shots in England, 10 times the convulsions. Other countries, narcolepsy. This stuff's frying your brain.
Absolutely. It's a nervous system aggravating injection. It's bad for your brain. It's bad for your nervous system. And it's bad for your immune system. It makes you more susceptible to a future flu. In fact, this brings me back to the Bill Gates quote, which is, he says one way to reduce or if we do a good job on vaccines and healthcare, he says, we could reduce the world population by 10-15%. That's pretty close to
Here's your article today. Okay. From Natural News. Here it is.
Okay, right. So that's here's it. Yeah. He says, if we do a really great job on new vaccines, healthcare, reproductive health services, we could lower that, which he's talking about the world population, by perhaps 10-15%. Well, how do you lower the population with vaccines? You weaken people's immune systems. You make them more susceptible to future infections. And then you just wait for something to come along, or you introduce something.
They have a word for it. This is called a binary weapon.
Yeah, exactly. Right. You've got to have both elements in place. One of them could be a wild virus, but the first element is the vaccine.
Well, now we're learning stuff in vaccines, viruses and RNA, is one of the things triggering Americans to be more obese. Not just the diet, it's that we're eating all this GMO and we're being shot up with these vaccines that are just frying us.
I think that there is an effort to diseaseify, if I could use that made-up word, to diseaseify America. And it's working.
It's a pestilence.
It is. Because they know that most Americans, they're going to spend every last dollar and they're going to give up their freedoms to try to save their lives if they're promised some kind of...
Yeah, these soft kill weapons, and I've actually seen the studies, it's designed, the stuff they're shooting you in vaccines are RNA packages, literally nanotech they've designed. That's what a virus is. It's natural nanotech. They argue, is it alive, or isn't it? But the point is, it's like a computer program that the viruses get into your cells, DNA, and mitochondrial, and it's designed that when your hormones drop, right around the time you're leaving work, right around the time that your body's starting to shut down to die over the next 20 years, we have that designed clock in us, that's when the viruses trigger. So they discovered in the 20s, the Rockefeller Foundation, and I have all their documents on this, what's so crazy, that they know then in their hormone test that, okay, you're done working, you've gone to menopause, or your testosterone's down, you're past 60. Now that's when this stuff gets triggered, and then you get cancer and die. It's so diabolical.
Mm-hmm. And that's when you're going to spend the most money on healthcare.
Yeah, all your money you save goes to them.
Exactly. You work your whole life, and you end up spending every last penny dying, suffering, and broke.